Hello students, looking at current affairs for 22nd April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these eight. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, ICMR asks states to stop using rapid antibody tests for the next 2 days. So Indian Council of Medical Research has directed the states not to use the COVID-19 rapid antibody testing kits for the next 2 days following reports of wide variations in results. So now the kits would be tested and validated by ICMR teams and an advisory issued in the next 2 days. And it is said if these kits are not found up to the mark, then replacements would be sought from manufacturers. Also, there are concerns regarding shortage of blood as such for blood transfusion. So portal has been asked to be used. This is eRakhosh. So this needs to be used is what the government emphasizes for the real-time status monitoring of current stock of each blood group, A, B, A, B and O, both positive and negative. Then next is huge spike in cases likely in Mumbai. So a 5-member interministerial central team has projected the number of COVID-19 cases in Mumbai will touch estimated 42,604 by April 30, 2020 and spiral to 6,56,407 by May 15, 2020. So we had seen earlier how central government has set up interministerial central teams for hotspots states in the country where COVID-19 cases have been found, and Maharashtra leads amongst the states in number of COVID-19 cases, and within Maharashtra it's Mumbai which is the hotspot. So here you can see a mathematical modeling has been done for Mumbai by the Union Ministry of Health, but the state government of Maharashtra is contesting the methodology and tools used for the latest projection and gap analysis. So here you can see as the projections for Mumbai, number of cases increase for April 30 and May 15, number of isolation beds without oxygen will see a deficit. Isolation beds with oxygen, ICU beds, ventilators will see a deficit. So the state of health infrastructure of the city of Mumbai, how there will be a deficit is also projected. So these assumptions are based on data collected from facilities on April 16, and infrastructure availability has been taken as a constant. So that is the doubling rate is taken as 3.8 days for Mumbai, and compounded average growth rate is taken as 20%. And number of deaths as percentage of total cases has been taken as 6.4% based on the data so far for Mumbai. Then next is at the rate COVID India Seva launched. So Union Health Minister Harshvardhan has launched COVID India Seva, which is an interactive platform to establish a direct channel of communication during the pandemic. So it will enable transparent e-governance delivery in real time and answering citizens' queries swiftly. So people can post their queries at the rate COVID India Seva on Twitter and get answers in almost real time. So here you can see it, what will happen is that at the rate COVID India Seva will work off as a dashboard, and at the back end, large volumes of tweets will be processed and converted into resolvable ticks and assigned to relevant authority for real time resolution. The next is humans to blame for pandemic. So it says whether this COVID-19 came from a bat or a pangolin is not certain, but one thing is certain that COVID-19 outbreak, coronavirus, has come from animal world. So it is not the first disease. Many diseases have been transmitted from animals to humans, and such diseases are called zoonosis or zoonotic diseases. So human activity has enabled virus to jump to people from animals. And specialists have warned that if things go on the way they are, then pandemics of this nature will follow in future as such too. So other diseases which have been transmitted from animals to humans are TB, rabies, toxoplasmosis, malaria, etc. So these are some of the diseases. So it is said 60% of the human infectious diseases originated from animals. And if you look at this figure, it will jump to 75% if emerging diseases are also taken into consideration, like Ebola, HIV, avian flu, Zika, SARS, and coronavirus as such too. So the emergence of zoonotic diseases are being associated with environmental changes and ecological disturbances. So the way forest land has been cleared for agriculture intensification, human settlements, etc., is a huge concern which is resulting in zoonotic diseases increasing. And the animal pangolin mentioned here, so you should know about this animal too. It is the only mammal to have scales. It doesn't look like a mammal, but it is. It is. So this is its image, pangolin. Bat is also a mammal. Then next is Beijing names disputed islands. So China has defended its naming of 80 islands and other geographical features in South China Sea, which has, and this move has angered neighboring countries in South China. So in South China Sea, so they also assert their territorial claim over the region, which China as such does too. So this has happened a day after China established a new administrative district for the contested Spratly and Paracel island chains. Vietnam also claims them, and it has said that Chinese action is seriously violating its territorial sovereignty. So this red line, also known as 9 dash line, shows China's claim, territorial claim in South China Sea, and it overlaps with the claims of other countries. So EEZ, exclusive economic zone as defined by UN clause, also allows countries to have claim in South China Sea region, and this overlaps with other with China. So you can see Vietnam's claim is shown here, which includes Paracel and Spratly Islands, which is also claimed by China. Then here is Malaysia's claim, Brunei's claim, etc., Philippines claim shown, which all overlap with China. So presently what has been done is China has named these 80 islands and other geographical features in South China Sea and established a new administrative districts for Spratly and Paracel Islands too. Then next is regulator Sweden's targeted long-term rep cooperation deal for banks lending to NBFCs, non-banking finance companies. So RBI has allowed banks to exclude loans extended to NBFCs from the funds availed under targeted long-term rep cooperations for determining priority sector targets. So this is intended to incentivize banks to lend to NBFCs. So banking regulator had announced targeted long-term rep cooperations worth 50,000 crores for banks on April 17. Earlier two TLTRO has been announced by RBI, you can see. So the first one, long-term rep cooperations of 1 lakh crore was announced, and then you had targeted long-term rep cooperations of another 1 lakh crore announced by RBI, and now on April 17 it was 50,000 crore targeted long-term rep cooperations too been announced. So this has been the latest announcement on 17 April. So in this, now NBFCs will not be considered under priority sector targets. So here you can see when this targeted long-term rep operations were also announced, it was said at least 50% of the total funds availed by banks should be invested in mid and small sized NBFCs, including microfinance institutions. And if the banks fail to deploy the funds availed within 30 days, then there will be steep penalties. So this RBI had already announced. Now it has announced that these will not be priority sector targets. So banks are further incentivized to lend to NBFCs. Then here you have NBFCs seek RBI clarification on what constitutes a default. So non-banking finance companies are planning to write to RBI to seek clarification, because RBI has said that if there is a default, then additional provisions should be made for such accounts. So non-banking finance companies also will have to make this provision. So there is a 10% provision now mandated. It should be equally spread over two quarters, from Jan to March and April to June, if there is a default. But what is a default? The term default is not defined in the circular which RBI has issued. There are multiple interpretations, because a loan can be termed as a default even if repayment is due for even one day. And according to RBI norms, there are these terminologies: special mention account, SMA 0, SMA 1 and SMA 2, which are dependent on the number of days the repayment is overdue. For 0 to 30 days, then it is called SMA 0, special mention account 0, 31 to 60 days SMA 1, and 61 to 90 days, then it is called SMA 2. So this is shown here too. So NBFCs are seeking clarification from RBI what constitutes a default and when this additional 10% provisioning will have to be made. So provisioning means when the bank's assets are actually loans which it has given. So standard assets of banks are regular loans, loans where there is no delay, repayment is coming. So banks earn interest and they are gaining from it. But stressed assets are those where there is delay in payment. So stressed assets are up to 90 days, it means SMA 0, 1 and 2. So they are also further classified depending on the amount of delay. So these are stressed assets. And then you have non-performing assets when the delay is more than 90 days. That are also further segregated as substandard, doubtful and loss assets, which are non-recoverable. It depending on how long they have been NPAs. So this is the classification you should know. And the last news is oil hits 2-decade low on demand, storage woes. So US crude futures slumped in a dramatic fashion, with the front month May 2020 contract falling close to a negative $37.63 a barrel, means minus $37.63 a barrel. So this is futures, means the future price as such, which is being proposed. So actually the prices have gone in the negative. The reason for this being that traders are scrambling to get out of the contract to avoid taking delivery of barrels for fear of nowhere to store the oil and lack of customers who want to buy it. So worldwide, the COVID-19 has brought economy to a halt and demand for crude has drastically reduced. So futures have gone in the negative, future prices on the stocks. So here you can see, this is US oil prices, how they have turned negative. So that is it. Thank you.